All right, good Sunday morning, everybody, live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick weather update for the early morning hours of Sunday. Things are very quiet for right now, but we may be seeing more active conditions in the Mid-South as we get into the course of the rest of the day today, as in the possibility of looking at more showers and thunderstorms out there. Got some warm air aloft, and that's doing a very good job of keeping things very much on the quiet side, but it is also going to be possible for that warm air cap to break, and that could be a bit of a problem into the rest of the day for more showers and thunderstorms across much of the Mid-South. So if you have any plans for outdoors, keep the umbrella handy because we could be looking for more potential problems out there as we get into the rest of the day today. Again, remember, when thunder roars, go indoors. That's going to be one of the best things you can remember. It may sound like a silly catchphrase, but it's designed to make certain that you stay safe, so please keep that in mind if you're going to be doing anything outdoors. Welcome to all of our viewers on Periscope and Twitter. Thanks for joining us for this morning. Give me 1 second while I get our Facebook patrons in here. And once again, having some difficulty connecting. Not entirely surprising about that, but as of right now, again, showing the potential for, again, a few more showers and thunderstorms out there. If you'd like to know more about what's going on with the forecast, information right here in the blue bar. Again, find out more at our forecast page at WREG.com/weather for more information. Let's go ahead and get going for this morning. Let's do a quick check of radar, which, again, does not have much of anything going on across much of the area. Sissy Karakurt, welcome to the show. Thanks a lot for joining us. Hopefully the wedding plans are going well from what it sounds like. And congratulations, by the way. Again, looking at the area right now, showing little, if anything, in the way of showers or thunderstorms for the time being. But as we get into the rest of the day today, more chances of rainfall coming up, and that again could be a problem for outdoor activities, so that's something to keep in mind as you head through the rest of the day. Let's take a look and see what's going on out there where it comes to anything involving the possibility of any fog out there. We've got some visibilities in the Mid-South around about a quarter mile, so we do have again the potential for some problems with fog. We are seeing that again around Millington, about a quarter mile reported there. Also at the airport in Tunica, about a quarter mile in that location. 1 mile in Bolivar at the Whitehurst Airport, about a mile and a half, mile and three quarters over toward the Tennessee River Valley, and beyond that, just not that much in the way of dense fog, but enough to be noticeable out across much of the area. Let me switch over here for just a second so we can take a look at temperatures in the Mid-South. And we'll ramp the forecast size numbers up so you can see more about that. We won't be taking a look at heat indexes just yet. It's not too hot for that, but temperatures, as you can see, across the area back in the mid to upper 60s to around about the lower 70s. Thanks to everybody for joining me on Periscope and Twitter for this morning as well. Currently in the tropics, really good news of a sort. Jose is no longer an issue. We do not have anything in the way of problems from Jose showing up at this point in time, so things pretty quiet out that direction. Marcia Couples, welcome from West Memphis. Gladys Clark, fall weather is on the way. We'll talk about that coming up here in just a little bit. Lee is a hurricane out into the Atlantic, way out into the Atlantic, 75 knots, 85 mile per hour winds, and expected to kind of wander on through the Atlantic Ocean into the next few days, pulling a maneuver like Jose's in the last few days, kind of looping the loop as it works its way back out into the Atlantic. No threat to Bermuda or anything else, so good news on that. Maria, on the other hand, lost some power overnight. Winds are down to 110 miles per hour. That's fairly good news, but there could still be some re-strengthening, although it looks less and less likely. Here's something to consider, though. If you are going to be traveling, the computer models are starting to lean this thing just a little bit farther to the west. Now, that takes it just off the Outer Banks of North Carolina, and that could be a bit of a problem. It looks like it's going to remain a Category 2 hurricane or less into the next couple of days, so there's really not that much to worry about in the way of a direct hurricane strike. But here's the other thing to think about. Round about this thing, it's going to be pulling water away from the shoreline. That could create some riptides, so if you're planning on going there to the coast for a nice vacation, could be, again, a lot of water leaving the coast, and that could, again, create some dangerous riptide conditions. also some winds and squalls as the circulation around this thing sends some winds and waves that direction. So we could be looking at some dangerous conditions out there with storms and rain and wind and stuff like that. But not for the Mid-South. And there's also, want to reiterate, nothing going on for the Gulf of Mexico. So very quiet conditions seen here at this point. So good news, we're down one storm. Jose is no longer an issue. And that should, again, continue into the next couple of days. Matter of fact, what's left of Jose is just that mass of clouds wandering around the northwest Atlantic. There's just really not that much left of him at this time, so very quiet. Maria, again, need to keep an eye on that over the next few days, and we'll keep you updated on that. Michael King, welcome from Dyersburg. Thanks for joining us for this morning. Here in the Mid-South, again, we've got little, if anything, taking place in the way of major amounts of problems for the next several days. Now, we will be looking at the possibility of more chances of showers and thunderstorms developing into the area as we get into later on today. So for the 7-day forecast, we are going to put in the possibility of, again, a 30% chance of some showers and thunderstorms for today. But as you notice, again, for the rest of the week, we really have little, if anything, going on where it comes to anything involving rainfall. Drier weather setting in, and if you take a look back toward the end of this next week, finally getting that chunk of cold air making its way off of Canada. That's going to be doing a good job of taking our temperatures in the right direction downwards. So we'll be looking for numbers in the high 70s by the time we hit Friday and Saturday. Yeah, yesterday we did have some temperatures in the 60s. Forecast has kind of resolved itself a little bit. And keep in mind that this thing is still, again, way far out in the future, about 7 to 10 days. So it could very easily alter one direction or the other. Current possibilities, again, keep us in the 80s as we go toward the end of next weekend, but the lower 80s at this time and staying that way as we get into, again, the later portions of next week as we go into October. But again, that's pretty normal for this time of the year, so we're not really too worried about that. More information about the forecast, join me at WREG.com/weather if you'd like to see more about what's going on there, just to be on the safe side. Also, join me if you're not on Facebook. Tons of information, again, available here in regards to your forecast science, a little bit of weather humor thrown in. Also on my Twitter page if you're not there already, and also on my Periscope page as well. Again, watching what goes on here for the area for today and tonight and tomorrow. And again, keeping you updated as to what's going on in your forecast to keep you updated here. Also, don't forget about our Weather Overtime page. It's available at WREG.com. That's where we post this. If you didn't have a chance to see it, you can catch it at WREG.com. And go to our weather page, again, for more information and a good opportunity to see more about that. Didn't catch the forecast with enough time this morning on Daybreak. Join me on the East Arkansas Broadcast Network on Country 92.5 or Oldies 102.3. And, of course, I'll be on live with Bob and Josh coming up bright and early tomorrow morning on News Channel 3's forecast on AM 730 Yahoo Sports Radio. Beautiful day a couple days ago in the Mid-South. Again, Germantown showing, again, a beautiful view from our WeatherBug camera. Sunlight striking the top of the towers, the Clark Towers area back out toward Poplar and Mendenhall off there in the distance. Beautiful morning shaping up so far. Hot and humid today with a chance of showers and thunderstorms, and that patchy fog, whatever we have of it, going to be burning off into the rest of the day today. Another check of your forecast. I got to get back out on set to finish up Daybreak. My co-anchor Nina Harrelson is out there right now. Mike Sadie's on with an update of sports at this time, and we'll have more throughout the rest of the weekend. 5:30 tonight after football on our Anytime channel, and after a late night tonight, we'll be on at 10:30, a little bit later this evening on News Channel 3 with the late edition. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining me for today's complete weather update, Sunday morning's edition of News Channel 3's Weather Overtime, and stay tuned to News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the weekend for further updates.